welcome to another finger picking lesson. Marco here. Today I want to talk to you about writing stuff on the guitar, and I want to show you the five different steps that I usually follow when I write my things. Now, if you've been following me for a while, you know that I write a lot of stuff, I write a lot of exercises, and I like to write musical stuff, okay? And so you have to have a system that really allows you to just create something from scratch and then slowly build up and make things interesting for the audience. So I'm gonna show you these five different steps that I really like to use a lot, okay? So each step is a little bit more difficult as we adding more things, okay? So really take it step by step, guys. This lesson was inspired by one of my patrons. His name is Martin, and he showed me this beautiful Latin Spanish intro, which I really liked, and I thought, you know what, I'm gonna use it to make this really cool lesson, okay? So thank you so much, Martin, for sharing that. And speaking about my Patreon page, make sure that you check my Patreon page so that you can download the tab as well as have access to the video with the tab on screen, okay? So you will have the same video like this one, but with the tab on screen so that you can follow what I play. Now guys, if you like finger picking guitar, make sure that you subscribe to this channel as we add new lessons on a weekly basis. So if you wanna learn stuff, that's the place. Now let's get started. Let me show you these five steps and let's have fun. Now guys, the five steps are very simple. Step number one, establish the chord progression. Step number two, the three notes rule. Step number three, melodic approach. Step number four, diversify chords. And step five is clear ending. So these are the five steps. Now, let's just check each one of those five steps so that we can really understand what to do. All right guys, step number one, you wanna establish the chord progression, okay? This is really important, obviously, it's the first step. Now, the chord progression we are playing today is this one, it's the C major, A minor, E minor, okay? And I'm using a very simple arpeggio, right? Now, the C major, we're going to play like this. You have the A string fret 3 and the B string fret 1. You also have the G open string. Now, we're always gonna play the B string with the middle, the G string with the index, and the the bass note with the thumb. Now, with the C major, we're gonna be playing with the thumb on the fifth. So I play the fifth string, and then the B string, and then the G string, okay? I'm gonna do that twice. Now, the A minor chord is this one. You're gonna be playing the A open, and the B string fret number one, and the G string fret number two. It's a pretty simple chord, same arpeggio. Okay, and then we're gonna be playing the E minor chord, okay? Which is going to be played with the E open string, and then the G open string, and the B open string. So really just open strings. I'm plucking the sixth, the second, and the third. Now the E minor will have four patterns. So it's one, two, and it's really important that you memorize the structure as well, so that you know that the E minor is two bars, so it's kind of a longer chord, so that we can add more things as we progress with the different steps, okay? So C major, three, and four. Now, step number two. Now, I call the step number two the three notes rule. And what that means is I'm going to add two, max three notes to what I just played, okay? So I wanna kind of spice it up a little bit, but not go crazy. I don't wanna go crazy, at least not yet, okay? And so for this type of chord progression, I really wanna add a bass line. I feel like I wanna, okay, and then just add a little melody, okay? Now, this is more than three notes, probably four notes, but, you see what I mean. I'm just trying to spice up the chord and maybe add something on the E minor, which is such a long chord, so we kind of want to add something. Now, what I'll do on the C major, I'm going to add something before I start playing the chord. Okay, and I'm going to start with the A open string. and then I'm gonna be playing the fret number 2, and then the fret number 3, which will be the first note I play for the C major, okay? So A, B, and then the C, and when I pluck the C, I'm actually playing the same thing that we just learned for the step 1. Okay? Now the only thing that we're gonna change here for the arpeggio is that the first time we play the chord, the C, we will have the same picking pattern. It's just 5th string, 2nd string, and 3rd string. The second time we play it, we're gonna be playing only the 5th string and then the 2nd string. And the reason for that is because I need, you know, the space here to play the second line I'm adding with the bass note. So I kind of have to adjust a little bit, guys, okay? So. And then the A minor, okay? Now, once I'm done with the arpeggio on the C, I'm gonna be playing the A string fret number 3, fret number 2, and I play the 5th open string, the A open string, which will be the first note I am playing for the A minor chord. And I play the 5th string, and then the B string, and the G string, then the A string again, and the B string, okay? Again, this picking pattern is one note shorter, okay? So, and then after that, I'm playing the E minor chord, okay? And before I play the E minor, I'm playing this nice bass note, bass line here. The E string fret number 3, we start with the E string fret 3, fret 2, and the 6th open, the E string, okay? Now I pluck them, and then I play the B string and the G string. I'm gonna play that twice. And then what I'll do, okay, I'm playing this beautiful, simple line, okay, which is the E open and the E open on the 1st string, and then the E string fret number 2, 3, 5, and the E open again. Okay, so as you can see, we just added few notes, okay? Now we move on to the step number 3, okay, which we're going to, really kind of spice up the chords a little bit more. Now I call the step 3 melodic approach, and what it means is we can, we can use chords in a melodic way, okay, and this is a really important step because it will take you from playing chords to actually play melodic chords, which are chords that sound more like a melody. Okay, so this is what we're gonna learn right now, okay? Now, as you can see, there is a little bit more going on. We're still playing the same chord progression. And I'm gonna start with this beautiful C major 7 chord, okay, sharp 11. And what I'm playing here is, like, I want to give a little bit more space, and I want the chord to sound different than just the basic chord, okay? And because I want the chord to sound melodic as well, I'm playing obviously the root note, and then I'm playing this F sharp here, followed by a G. So it's just like playing a melody on the chord, because I'm playing an F sharp going to the G. Now, rather than play it on one string, I'm playing on two different strings. Okay? So what I'm playing? The A string fret number 3, which is the root note, and then the D string fret number 4, which is the F sharp, which is the sharp 11. And then the G open string. Okay? So again, I'm changing picking pattern, but obviously this is necessary to, just change things around on the chord progression. I play this picking pattern twice. I play with the thumb, and then the index on the 4th, and the G, and the middle finger on the G. I play this pattern twice. Now, when I play the A minor chord, I don't want to go back playing the chords. I want to play kind of a melody. And then back to the E minor and I play a chord. So the A minor will be used as just a melodic, for a melodic approach, melodic purpose. So I play the fifth open string, which will give me the root note of the chord. Okay? And then after that, I'm playing this phrase, which basically is just an E minor scale starting on the F sharp here. So I play the fifth string, and then the D string fret number 4 and 5, the G string fret number 2, 4 and 5, and then the B string fret number 3, fret number 7, and fret number 5. Okay? So the first two chords. Now, once I'm done playing the E here on the B string fret 5, I'm going to play the E minor chord, okay? So I'm gonna pluck the second string fret 5, then the E string with the thumb, and then I'm playing this beautiful E minor chord, okay? Which is played on the D string fret number 5 and the G string fret number 4. That's like an E minor triad, okay? So B string, 6th string, and 4th and 3rd string. You let it ring out, okay? So, okay, now this phrase, it's something that I need, something that I have to play to connect the step 3 to the step 4, okay? And so I need this phrase because on step 4 I want to play a chord in a different position here. So I need a line, a phrase that really connect these two steps, okay? So I need to go up. And what I'm playing on this E minor, I'm playing basically this beautiful pattern. I start with the 6th open, so the E string. And then on the B string, I play the fret number 3 with a hammer-on on the fret 5, okay? And then the first open string, okay? So I have basically 4 notes, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? Where the 3rd note is a hammer-on. So 6th string, B string fret 3, hammer-on on fret 5, and the E open string, okay? Then I'm gonna play the 6th string again. And then I'm playing the B string fret 5, hammer on fret 7, and the E open, okay? Then the 6th string again, B string fret number 7, hammer on fret 8, and the 1st open. And the last one, 6th open string, B string fret number 8, hammer on fret 10, and the 1st open. So it's always the same pattern. So the whole thing, the step number 3 is basically using chords in a melodic way. Okay, before we move on to the step number 4, okay, which is obviously different. Now let's check it out. Now, the step number 4 is called diversify chords, and it's extremely important, guys, that you are able to come up with the same chord progression in a different position, because that will help you to really spice up the chords. Now, the chords that we're going to play here are those, and we're coming from this section. As you can see, I'm playing a lot of things here, but it's always the same chord progression, okay? So once you're done with them, we're gonna be playing the C major chord like this, okay? So I'm playing the E string fret number 8, which is my root note, and the B string fret number 10, the G string open, and the first E string open. Okay, so it's thumb, middle, index, and ring. And this is, guys, just a beautiful C major chord with the G here on the, sorry, with the A on the B string. It's a beautiful C6. Now the A minor and the E minor. So now the A minor chord I'm playing here, I have the fifth string open, and then the G string fret number 5, B string fret 5, and the E string fret number 8. Okay, I pluck the fifth string, and then I pluck simultaneously the G, the B, and the E string. And then I'm gonna keep going with the melody. So fret number 7 on the E string and fret 5. So, and then the B string fret number 8 and the E string fret number 5 and fret number 7. So, and then we're playing the E minor. So the E minor is pretty simple here. You have the sixth open string simultaneously with the E string fret number 7, okay? Pluck that simultaneously. And the B string and the E string. Very simple. And now I need a phrase here that leads me to the position 1 again as we're going towards the step number 5, okay? So I want a phrase that leads me down here. And the melody I'm playing here is very simple. So I'll be playing the E string on the 6th string and the high E on the fret 12, okay? Then fret 10. Fret 8, 7, 5, and the E open. So that's the first thing you want to learn. But because we're also playing chords, I want to add the chords as well. So I'm playing this beautiful arpeggio on the E minor chord, okay? Where I'm plucking simultaneously the E string and the high E with thumb and ring finger, then the B string and the G string with middle and index, okay? So then I'm playing the fret 10, fret 8, and 7. Okay, so now when I play the fret 5, I only play the E string and the B string, and then the E open string. So, so you have, okay, pretty quick, but it sounds beautiful. Now we got to this point, so we move on to the step number 5, okay? Let's check it out. Now the step 5 is called clear ending, and obviously we want to make sure that when we are done with this guitar part, you want to make sure that it sounds like we ending this beautiful idea we're writing. And so we're going to change one chord. One thing that I really like to do a lot is to change at least one chord in the chord progression so that it kind of sounds different and conclusive, okay? So we're coming from here, playing a C and a D add 9. That's it, okay? So the C add 9 is pretty easy chord to play. Okay, we have a beautiful melody on it as well. So you have the A string fret number 3, and the B string fret 3, and the E string fret number 2, okay? So you want to pluck the 5th string, and then you play the B string and the E string, okay? Then I'm playing the E string fret 3 with a little finger and the E open. So I have this beautiful melody going on the 1st string. One more time slowly. And then the D. So the D add 9 chord is a beautiful sounding chord. It's a little bit stretchy. You can do it with the D basic chord, but we're going to do it with the D add 9. So you have the D string open, the G string fret 2, and the E string fret number 5, and the E string fret number 2. Okay? Beautiful sounding chord. And I'm plucking the D string, the G, the B, and the E. So. And then I'm playing a melody, which is on the E string, fret number 3, 2, open, and the B string, fret number 3. Okay, so. Finish with the B string fret 5 and the 6th open, which will be the E minor chord. So, five steps, guys. Really take it step by step. Let me know if you like this lesson, and I'll see you on the next video.